In this video, I'm gonna tell you guys why your very first ever catastrophe deployment is hands down the very most important thing that you can do in your career and for your career, so that you can actually have a shot at making the kind of money that you always heard that you could make doing cat property claims. What's up, Matt here with Adjuster TV, and for the best tips and tools for getting on the first call list as an independent catastrophe property claim. I mean, just look at this view. I mean, this is just insane all the way around. Subscribe now. Click on the bell notification to, you know, scare off the bears. And thanks to CLOS, or Kloss, from YouTube, who says, during Hurricane Sandy, I worked as an admin for one of the largest cat companies in the country. I sent so many new adjusters home because they couldn't keep up with the workload. They weren't prepared for the conditions, and they couldn't handle the emotional aspects of the job. Well, first of all, thank you so much for watching, CLOS. Second of all, I worked as a field support slash field trainer on Sandy, probably for the same company you did. And you're absolutely right. Easily hundreds of new adjusters disappeared from that storm every single week. And why? Exactly what you said. They couldn't keep up with the workload, they definitely weren't prepared for the conditions, and they couldn't handle the emotional aspects of the job. Emotional aspects, what does that even mean? I don't wanna put words into CLOS's mouth. I'm gonna call you Kloss. I don't wanna put words in your mouth, but I would call this emotional aspect anything to do with dealing with insureds, contractors, storm managers, and dealing with the incredibly high levels of anxiety and stress that come with working a massive cat like Hurricane Sandy, from the volume of work that's asked of you. And you know what else? Many of those new adjusters who got sent home note that he said, or she, Kloss sent them home. They were kicked off the storm. Most of those adjusters spent thousands of dollars and hours, weeks, and months of their own time on their own dime, getting ready for a storm just like Sandy. They got kicked off the storm. Never mind the other adjusters who were crushed under the workload and decided they couldn't handle it and turned their files back in, packed up their stuff, and went home to try and figure out some other way to make an uncommon income like this. And I wish them the best of luck. So let's talk about this. Those new adjusters Kloss was talking about were most likely on their first ever storm deployments, and they failed. Listen, you can have a claims career and not do CAT. You can do daily claims, you can do inside claims, or you can go be a staff adjuster at a great company and have a great career. But you're not here watching this video because you just want a regular old claims career. You're here because you want to make the big bucks, and there's really only one way to do it for most people, and that's cat property claims. Becoming a cat property IA, a successful one, means working through the storm season, which is typically March through October, and earning upwards of $100,000, in many cases, a lot more. So let's see, March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October. 8 months, $100,000. That's not even the full year. So without a college degree, almost without a high school diploma, you can earn up to six figures in less than a year. Less than a year. People spend $150,000 or a lot more to get a bachelor's degree so that they can graduate from 4+ years of school and make $35,000 a year to start. And maybe in 10 or 15 years, they'll get closer to $60,000 to $70,000. And maybe they become a manager with even more responsibility and even more hours. And never mind that they're working 12 months instead of our 8, right? So this math is real simple. So what are you gonna do with those other 4 months? Whatever the heck you want. You wanna protect those cat earnings and work another easy to get, easy to quit job? Go for it. You wanna be a stay-at-home dad or mom? You can. Want to pack the family up and go for a long vacation? do it? And what is standing in the way of you getting all of this? It's your first storm, okay? Those things only exist on the other side of your first ever successful cat deployment. So how does this even work? If you're successful on your first storm, this establishes you as somebody who gets it. You can be highly trained in every possible aspect of running property claims, but if you don't get while you're really on cat, then you'll wallow around and waste time. The part that you have to get is all about being able to handle extremely high stress and pressure from all sides at all times. And here's the truth. IA firms and carriers are looking for people like you. You can perform under extreme pressure day in and day out for weeks, many times months, and in some cases even years without your quality suffering. This is the kind of person that they want handling claims for them. If you do well on your first cat, if you get it, they'll give you more new claims on that cat if they have them. They might even ask you to stay after and do cleanup duty. If you get that offer, that means they trust you enough to help them clean up after the other adjusters who botched the job, likely the ones that Kloss sent home. And what does all that mean? It means you'll be known. When your IA firm knows who you are, it's because you impress them and the carrier. And make no mistake about it, the carriers are tracking how all the IAs are doing, probably even more than the IA firms themselves. They will put you on a list of desired adjusters for future cat deployments. We call it the first call list, and it's a nice place to be. So how does a first call list work? Well, Acme Insurance Company has a hailstorm hit an area that has a lot of their customers. They call 123 Claims IA firm and say, hey, we just had a big storm in Springfield and we need 125 adjusters. And if these 15 adjusters are available, we'd love it if you send them as well on this list. In other words, the carrier keeps the first call list. As a first call adjuster, you're the guy or gal who is out working in March on the tiny little hailstorm in Lincoln, Nebraska that will only produce enough work for about 8 adjusters while everybody else has to wait for a big storm in Dallas, or worse, a hurricane. And at the time of this video here, at the beginning of the peak of hurricane season, there ain't squat going on in the tropics right now. That could change in a day or two, or a week or two, or 2019 might pass by without anything other than Tropical Storm Barry giving us a little wetting. A little wetting. Other than Tropical Storm Barry giving us a little wetting. Bottom line, your first storm stands in the way of you getting on the first call list. You must be successful on your first storm if you want to be a cat property IA. There's no trying it out. There's no do-overs. Which brings me to, what if you're unsuccessful on your first storm? You may not get another chance again because the weather may not cooperate. Many brand new cat IAs get their big break on a big hailstorm or a big hurricane. Many IA firms will try to send out new IAs on hail and windstorms, but if they already sent you out as the newbie on a cat and you fail, that was your turn. The next storm is somebody else's turn. So it might take another 12 months or more before there's another really big event where you can try again. Not saying it's not possible, but now you've got to wait, and in the meantime, your family still has to eat. So then, what if you fail so badly you get kicked off the storm? You may not get another chance again with that same IA firm. The long and short of it is that your one big chance might just be that, your one chance to get this right. Listen, I'm not joking around with this. Carriers take even the smallest claims very seriously, and if you mess it all up and create a huge storm of angry customers, the carrier isn't going to want you around. And this reflects poorly on the IA firm who brought you in. So it's a lose-lose all the way around if you can't make it happen on your first storm. You've spent a lot of money, time, and resources getting ramped up to go on your first cat deployment. I sincerely hope I've made it clear just how important this is. Why would you ever take a chance on all this by not nailing your first storm? Question of the day. Would you like to know how to not get kicked off your first cat deployment as a property independent adjuster? I hope you'll check out my free live webinar at adjustertv.com/webinar. By the end of this webinar, you'll know the 3 things that will keep you from getting sent home early from your first cat. Plus, I'll go into detail on how we as IAs get paid and how much you can expect to earn on your first ever cat deployment. And there'll be a live Q&A so you can get your questions answered and a special opportunity at the end that I'm super excited to share with you. I truly hope you come and check it out. Again, adjustertv.com/webinar. Okay, for more information about crushing it as an independent adjuster, head on over to adjustertv.com. And if you got value from this video, you can help me create more videos just like this by subscribing to Adjuster TV on YouTube. Wondering what to watch next? There are tons more videos right here on the Adjuster TV YouTube channel. And as always, thank you so much for watching and have a great storm. I'm just gonna pan this thing around for y'all. You can see how gorgeous it is around here.
Let me know if he runs at me.
I'm making a little nervous.
He just wanted a little snack. He's going to go back and go sleep.
Oh, he smells what's in the bag.
Probably smells that salmon.
There we go.
What's he checking out down there?
Checking out JR.
I like wildlife, but a little bit further.
Well, hell, don't walk over here by us. There ain't no sense in all of us dying. He's a big old boy. No, don't come up here. We'll have to start throwing rocks at him if he gets any more.
Blow your whistle, Eric.
Huh?
Blow your whistle.
Nope.
Let's call him back.
All right. Good boy.
Your skills are gnarly right now.
Did you pee over there? So from our base camp this morning, it took us about 2 hours to get up here. That right there is Cashmere Peak. And over there somewhere is Mount Rainier, which is off in the distance. And then, Glacier Peak is over there. I don't know where I'm, it's over there somewhere. But I'm here hiking with my lovely wife, Dee Marie, and with JR. And with my buddy Eric, that he was actually my store manager on the carrier side back in 2001. It was my third storm ever. And so we've stayed friends ever since, which is pretty cool. Say hi, Eric. Eric also has a YouTube channel where he documents his backpacking trips. He lives here in Washington, and he's hiked a lot of these peaks around here. And I'm trying to get him to do some gear reviews and stuff on there, but I'll link to his channel down below, so check that out. March, April, May, June, July, August, September, October. I miscounted that.